And Democrats calling the president and his supporters racist without any proof.
Have a president of the United States who is a racist.
Do you believe President Trump is a racist?
Yeah, no question.
The birther in chief, the grand wizard of 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue.
So will this strategy work looking ahead to 2020? Here now to discuss is Republican strategist Kimberly Klasick. Thank you so much for joining us. We really appreciate your time this morning.
Thank you. Good morning.
So what do you think about that when you hear, you know, one potential candidate after another out on the campaign trail, specifically on MLK Jr. Day, talking like this and referencing our president as a racist?
It's actually really sad, Heather. It's so unfortunate that the one president that passed a prison reform bill, the one president that's trying to do something about the broken immigration system that usually has blacks scraping at the bottom of the barrel, we're labeling him a racist. Like, I like to point out to people that it was Lyndon Johnson, a Democrat, that convinced black families that we were stronger apart and pushed welfare dependency. It was Bill Clinton, a Democrat, that pushed the 1994 crime bill that led to mass incarceration of black people. Mm-hmm. And it was Bernie Sanders, who's there in your video clip, that actually signed that 1994 crime bill and supported it as well. So it's an easy out to always label someone white a racist because you can't prove or disprove it. But that's what they're doing, is they've got nothing else to go on.
And Kimberly, what is the problem? Why aren't we hearing more about the things that you just referenced, you know, and why aren't we hearing more about the benefits of the prison reform that he brought to the table? Black unemployment, that rate, which is at now 6.6%, you know, historic lows. And then we have approval rating among Latino voters, which is up 50% up, a 19-point jump from December. Why aren't we hearing more about these positive things?
Because actually they don't want to say anything positive about our president. But you know what's going to happen? In 2020, we're going to start to see the effects of that prison reform bill. We're going to see a lot of people that were locked up for long term for nonviolent crimes. They're going to start to come home and they're going to start to take advantage of that job training that's outlined in that bill. And then they're going to start taking advantage of that unemployment number and they're going to start landing jobs. And it's going to be hard to ignore that in the black community. And a lot of people are going to question just how racist our president truly is.
But it seems like it's not going to end, though, right now, because we talk about in the wake of this Covington Catholic High School issue, the viral video. Now they're saying, you know, the red hats are a sign of racism. If you even wear one, you're a racist. So it's moving beyond just the president to anyone who supports him.
Yeah, it's really going to rev up. And I don't understand why they make the Make America Great Again hat a symbol of racism, because I know many of black people that wear it. But I have to point out, if people want to see evidence of racism, they should look at cities like Baltimore, where the city officials have completely turned their backs on the violence and crime, driving businesses and job opportunities out of the city. They're now gearing up to demolish a housing project, Gilmore Homes, which will displace many black families and especially black senior citizens that are living on a fixed income that can't afford to live anywhere else. I think the Democrats made a mistake in 2016 in pushing this racism card, and they're going to make that mistake again in 2020, because when people go to vote, they vote on the amount of money in their pocket, not the amount of people claiming that our president is racist without any proof.
You know, I think it would do the president well, and I've been saying this for a while, to do some sort of town hall in a community like Baltimore on race and racism in America, and listen to what people have to say. And I think that would really benefit him. Kimberly, thank you so much for joining us. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Heather.